Hello and welcome to our channel. My name is Kirill and I'm a part of the Exactpro testing team. At Exactpro, we build software to test software. Check out our website exactpro.com if you want to learn more about us. If you're new to our channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to make sure you see all the new videos. In Test World Reboot, we're leading you through the story behind Test World, the fanfiction art we created based on HBO's critically acclaimed sci-fi TV series entitled Westworld. This review contains multiple spoilers, and we'd hate to ruin anything for you. But if you insist on staying anyway, just to find out what we have in stock for you today, I won't blame you. Westworld is a dystopian, state-of-the-art Wild West-themed amusement park, populated by android hosts. The park allows high-paying guests to live out their wildest fantasies in the vastness of the park without any restrictions and in the company of hosts who are programmed not to harm humans. Let's look at the scene where one of the main characters, William, is being onboarded. William's journey at Westworld starts as a general health checkup. The world is apparently tailored to how much a particular person can withstand physically and emotionally to make sure that the guests don't get any permanent damage while being there.
Do you often experience social anxiety?
What is this for exactly?
To make sure we don't give you anything more than you can handle.
So how does this work? Is there a orientation?
No orientation. No guidebook. Figuring out how it works is half the fun.
Our scene is a representation of a junior QA's health checkup before he's embarking on the testing journey. Before going in, he's confident that software testing is completely safe. However, he's given a hint that the search for defects may involve some pain and suffering. But it's nothing he can't handle.
Do you have any pre-existing medical conditions? Any history of mental illness, depression, panic attacks?
Just a little fear of Scrum. I'm joking.
Do you often experience social anxiety?
What is it for exactly?
To make sure we don't give you more to test than you can handle.
I thought that you couldn't get hurt here for submitting defects.
Only the right amount.
So, how does this software work? Is there a specification?
No specification, no guidebook. Figuring out how it works is half the fun.
There are countless roadblocks you face as a software tester. Faulty or incomplete specifications, regulatory compliance specifics, various system specifics, and many more. Software testers can encounter both well-documented systems and those that need to be explored empirically to really understand their functioning. What an inspiring QA engineer shouldn't be afraid of.
Just a little fear of Scrum. I'm joking.
Is definitely the unknown. Because in the unexpected, in the absence or lack of complete specifications, there can be no mistakes. There are only surprises. When William is first welcomed to the park, he is offered bespoke clothes and boots tailored exactly to his size, all kinds of ammunition and accessories that match the outfits supporting the Wild West theme of the park. He is told that in this world, his experience is only limited by his imagination. He has all the tools to experience his most coveted fantasies. At the same time, he is safe. He can't get hurt or hurt anyone who's not supposed to get hurt.
You want to ask, so ask.
Are you real?
Well, if you can't tell, does it matter?
Our young William is only entering the world of QA. He is apprehensive of the tools at his disposal. He doesn't know the extent to which they can be applied or how far he can take them. He is told that he can't really break anything in the system.
You want to ask, so ask.
Is it a bug or a feature?
Well, if you can't tell, does it matter?
Are those testing tools real?
Real enough, but you can't break anything in our system.
But is this really what software testing is about? What true software testing, test tools, and techniques are directly aimed at is finding the system's breaking point. If our processes are guided by anything other than this goal, we are getting dangerously close to doing fake testing instead. Fake testing is a practice characterized by a well-orchestrated simulation of testing processes and methods, rather than a set of techniques actually used to reveal the true state of the system. This is a serious and far-reaching issue. We're discussing it in more detail in a separate video entitled Fake Testing: The Pentagon Wars Film Review. Do check it out on our channel. We'll be sure to put the link in the description box below. We are now moving on to the next and final episode of Test World Reboot. In a flashback in season 2, Arnold and Ford organize a demonstration of the hosts to convince Logan Tellows to invest in Westworld. At first skeptical, Logan is ultimately stunned to discover that the hosts are indistinguishable from humans. He instantly sees value in the technology and the host's abilities.
Of course, if you want my full endorsement, you're gonna have to prove it.
Welcome to Westworld.
We're not here yet.
With our software testers playing the roles of the hosts, we wanted to highlight the idea that the best, most adaptable, flexible, and largest in scale software testing tool is the human brain. And the most valuable part of a technology vendor's toolkit is the software testing expertise of its team.
I thought we were talking about fully automated software testing. Do you know how many methodologies are out there? TDD, BDD, DevOps.
I think you'll find the test environment quite stimulating.
William, this is automated testing, and it's already begun.
You mean one of these people is?
Talk to them, see if you can pick them out.
Huh, well. That is delicious. What's the trick, pal? They're also painfully manual. Hang on, wait a minute.
You have quite the eye, my friend.
No, no way. How in the hell? There is simply no way. I mean, if I were to build something for corporate data warehouse, you would be my first test design. You're too perfect to be one of us. Nobody can do it. Nobody is even close. We're not here yet. Nobody is.
We are here, Mr. Tester, and all our tools are here for you. Welcome to Test World.
As of today, Exactpro employs a little over 600 specialists. We build software to test software for exchanges and clearing houses in 20 countries on all 6 continents. Having resilient systems is paramount in running the platforms that underpin global financial markets. Thorough software testing is fundamental in identifying problems that can affect system integrity. Software testing includes functional and non-functional testing. Functional testing ensures that the system works according to specifications and satisfies the compliance requirements. Non-functional testing spans the assessment of the system's performance, latency, capacity, reliability, and operability. Test automation decreases time to market and boosts verification coverage. However, automated testing should not be a substitute for manual testing activities. What's more, automating manual effort is a slow and resource-heavy undertaking. Automation is better off doing what a machine is intended to do, streamlining routine operations, and reducing the human factor while doing it. For instance, a comprehensive automated regression library allows QA to facilitate a large part of the verification checks. Nonetheless, humans' effort is indispensable for performing in-depth checks and continuously adapting the scenarios. Sometimes testing requires intuition, a hunch, sometimes creativity, and it always requires experience, excellent knowledge of the systems under test, and an analytical mindset. And it can't be done without an experienced team of highly skilled talent. This concludes today's episode of Test World Reboot. Thank you for staying with us. We do have lots more content for you. Feel free to give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Do you have any questions or comments? Let us know your thoughts below the video. Subscribe to the Exactpro channel. Remember to hit the bell button to be the first to see the new content. Feel free to follow us on social media to stay on top of all the updates. See you soon!